My name is Dedo, Dedo Matikuju. I'm one of the deputy regional directors in Horn, East and Central Africa for Oxfam. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about the changes that will be that Vision 2020 will bring to countries and the region. Now you're all aware that over the last 5-6 years we've been going through the SMS system, where we had a number of affiliates in a country. We had an OI regional director, OI country director, but all the affiliates had their own systems, although they signed up to a joint country strategy. Now, what Vision 2020 brings is all of us building one team. The process started a couple of years back with the development of the Oxfam's global strategy, and the fact that last year, almost all the countries had their country strategies signed off. Signed off in a very, very interesting way, because the affiliates came together, looked at it, and then signed it off. So for me, that's the beginning of the one program at country level. Secondly, what the Vision 2020 brings is one program team, one budget, and one strategy. If I want to talk about the country team, it means then that instead of having the affiliates having the various program teams, we're having everybody being brought together under one. What this implies is that we will be using the legal registration of one country, of one affiliate. This affiliate will be called the executing affiliate, and we'll use their registration, we will use, they will issue contracts for staff, as well as be the legal representation for Oxfam International in that particular country. We will use the executing affiliate's HR procedures until such a time that the OI shared services is finalized. What it also means is that in terms of governance, where previously we had a number of affiliates working in the country under the program governance group, now we're going to have what we're going to be calling a country governance group. This is all the affiliates who are keen and excited about a country strategy coming together to contribute either restricted funding or unrestricted funding, or even the provision of technical advice to the particular country, coming together to form the country governance group. Now, the country governance group also includes national stakeholders. So, for example, here in Kenya, we would have the affiliates who are interested in the Kenya program, as well as a number of national stakeholders who will provide the strategic direction and operational decision making to support the country director. So, in effect, the country director will be reporting into the country governance group. Previously, for example, Oxfam GB, the country directors were reporting into a deputy regional director. Now, this would be a thing of the past. Under the Vision 2020, the country director will be reporting into the OI regional director. And he or she will also be part of the country governance group. In a region like HECA, where we have 10 countries, what it means then that the regional director will be a member of the various country governance groups, and he will be reporting into the OI